Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Mia Bjorkman. I am the strings teacher here at Concordia International School. A very warm welcome to you all, and thank you for supporting our students. They have been working very hard over the last 3 days. One student even commented that this might be more intense than APAC tennis, where they were playing 4 tournaments a day. So that shows you how hard they've been working. Our first piece only has one movement, so please do applaud after the first movement. Some of our other pieces have 3 movements. So just like 3 chapters in a book, this is all part of one storyline. So we ask you to please hold your applause until after the 3rd movement. Our guest conductor is the professor of conducting at Amsterdam Conservatoire, and he has come all the way from Netherlands to work with our students. So please put your hands together for Maestro Arjan Tien.
Thank you. Cheers, Chief.
I'm afraid that's why my Chinese stops with my Mandarin. Thank you very much. Welcome to this concert. We've been working quite hard. This first piece was by Johann Strauss, written in 1892. And I'm mentioning that date not because it's so interesting to know all the dates of the compositions when they were written, but the next work that we're going to play by Edvard Grieg is composed in 1884, and the work after that by Elgar is also from 1892. So you're hearing three works in a row from absolutely the same period, but quite different styles, as you will notice. The next work by Grieg was written to commemorate the 200th birthday of Ludwig Holberg, a Danish author that he wanted to celebrate. And because of the period of Holberg being 1684, he decided to compose those pieces in the style of the late 1600s, although it was a very romantic period. So it's basically neo-baroque with a romantic coating. We're playing three movements from this work, the Preludium, the Sarabande, and Andante Religioso.
Thank you.
Thank you. Some people have asked why the orchestra is seated the way we're seated now, as opposed to have the first to hear, the second violins there, the violas there, the celli and the basses there. In the times that the composers that we're playing today were composing this music, this was the regular setup of the orchestra, and for a reason. So that the dialogue between the first and the second violins could clearly be distinguished and heard. If you have the first and the second violins in one corner, it sounds like a monologue rather than a dialogue. And basically all the composers from the Baroque era up to 1910, 1920, which means after Mahler, would have had this setup in mind. And clearly the compositions gain a lot of expression when you can hear the dialogue between the first section, as you could now just in the work composed by Grieg as well. The next work is by Edward Elgar. He wrote this when he was quite young, just 30 years old, and still not able to provide for a living for him, his wife, and his kid. 30 years old, he was doing some other things as well, accompanying, teaching, and after that he broke through and he, of course, became the well-known and celebrated composer as we know him. This piece, as I said before, composed in the same year as the piece by Strauss, 1892, has three movements, and the first and the second movement have a particular character, quite boisterous and uplifting. The first one will have a wonderful viola section featuring in the very opening, and that motif you will hear coming back several times, even in the last movement when he combines the themes from the first two movements. A very nice little work, intimate, and enjoy.
Thank you.
The last work in the program is by an Azerbaijan composer called Kara Karayev. He was a student of Shostakovich, and he wrote a lot of symphonies and ballets, opera, string quartets, and out of his ballets, three miniatures were selected, and that is out of the ballet called The Seven Beauties. The story, or at least some of it, is about Aisha. She is a young girl, young woman, who is in love with Manzar. And unfortunately, also the Sheikh or the Shah, Basram, had his eye on her. She didn't really respond to his advances and to his love. And at some point she was kidnapped, but she escaped, she fled, and in the end she was captured again by the evil Shah. And as I explained also to our orchestra, what do? When you're jealous and you can't have her, you kill her. So that's what we will try to do in the last movement, and then we go and party. The first two movements, the first movement is a lullaby, and the second movement reminds perhaps of the Carmen opera. It has the same sort of accompaniment as the habanera from Carmen, although the texture is completely different, somewhat primitive in the taste of folkloristic approach. Enjoy these three lovely miniatures by Kara Karayev.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I first of all want to thank parents for lending us your children for the last 3 days so that we could have this wonderful concert this evening. There is going to be a ceremony. I'm here for logistics. There's going to be a ceremony in about 10 minutes or so to formally thank all the schools for coming to the APAC as an APAC closing. And so we're going to need a few things to happen. Students, you're going to put your instruments completely away. Basses, everything, put them in cases. If you're from this school, take them upstairs. But completely put them away. And then once you finish that, you're going to come and sit on top of these people. Step one. These people are going to move. And so that we can sit the students here for their closing. You are welcome to join us for that closing. It's just that we need this about for the students. So you're welcome to join that. In between, there may be a moment for you to see your child if you're here representing one of these children. But so that ceremony will take place in about 10 minutes. So thank you. And again, can we have a gigantic round of applause for these students? Good evening. Thank you again, students, for what was a memorable performance for those of us who had the pleasure to sit down and listen while you got to sit down and do all that work. It is my distinct pleasure to start off our closing ceremony by bringing out to thank Mr. Arjen Ten, the wonderful conductor who really brought out the best in you, I believe. To thank on behalf of Concordia and on behalf of APAC, Ms. Mia Bjorkman, who is our strings teacher here. Mia, come on up. While I handled tiny bits of logistical pieces, Mia handled the lion's share of musical decisions and on your behalf, really. So thank you very much, Mia.
Like to thank each and every director from all the traveling schools that are here today, and please make a point of personally thanking your directors for all the time and effort that they've put into making this concert such a success. So can we give them all a big round of applause? I would like to call up each director and just please stay on stage for a photo. So first we had leading the first violins in our sectionals was Mr. Tony Yu from SAS Kidal. From Western Academy of Beijing, Miss Brenda Lee was helping us with the cello sections. And from AISG, Miss Lisa Mary Giuliani, helping us with the bass sectionals. And last but definitely not least, unfortunately, this is Mr. Daryl Townsend's last APAC as he will be transitioning into retirement next year. So for all his years of dedication to APAC and to the fine arts, please give a big round of applause to Mr. Daryl Townsend. Before you leave.
Thank you, directors. There's one other person who it's important for us to recognize, and he does not like the spotlight. On Thursday night when we had the symphony here, he was behind the curtains making sure that transitions were working. And that person's Mr. Daryl Roddick. He told me previously, I hate flowers. Never give me flowers. He's probably not going to have a day off until Christmas with all of the festive concerts coming up. So what I did instead of flowers is a voucher for a massage. You definitely need one. And well, what an incredible show. Thank you so much to our guest conductor, Mr. Ten. And for our students from the six different APAC schools, you have had a quite unique experience here at APAC. I think you have been pushed. Your potential is maybe more than what you thought it was with the way that you were pushed to perform by Mr. Ten. I think you were treated not like students in a school. You were treated like professional musicians, and that was probably uncomfortable sometimes for you. And so we thank Mr. Ten for sharing that experience with all of you. And this is one of the things I would say that being in an APAC school makes your experience somewhat unique. Most international schools in the world have conferences for their sports. Some have festivals for the arts. But there's something very special about APAC and how we do the arts festivals. So again, just a really big thank you to Mr. Arian Ten for the experience our students have had the last few days. Students, could you show your appreciation for him, please? Thank you. To now introduce our head of school with a closing message, Mr. Steve Winkleman.
Thank you. I do want to thank Mr. McInnes, who did so much work, and his entire team to make sure that this APAC event happened. So we appreciate that and all your time spent. So thank you. I had a chance to talk with you guys a couple days ago. In your lives, that probably seemed like a really long time ago, because the last 3 days have been incredibly intense. You've been pushed, at times against your will, to get better, right? I mean, you think about how hard it was over the last few days to do the things that you did. But we talked about some of the goals that we have in APAC. One of the goals was to push to excel. And in talking with Mr. Tien, he definitely did that. He pushed you guys to excel, and you stepped up and accomplished that. And to me, that's something you should be really proud of. That's one of the really unique things about this is you get to be around people that are equally talented as you, that are all driven to excel. And that's the great thing about APAC. That was one of the goals that we had here. Another goal for APAC that we had and we talked about on Thursday morning when we were here, you probably don't remember it, but if you think way back to Thursday, we talked about the opportunity to connect with people from other schools and make some friends. As you look back on your last few days, how many of you, by a show of hands, this is the interactive part of our performance now, made a friend that wasn't from the school you're at? Somebody that you can go to and say later. All right. That's one of the things we want. We want you to have those interactions. We want you to have those bonding experiences that we can look back and say, hey, I know somebody who's in Shanghai, or I know somebody who's in Beijing that has the same passion for something that I do. And that's an important part of what we do in APAC. And the other thing that's an important part of what we do is just the opportunity to grow and learn. And that happens through your instructors, and I know we've recognized and thanked them, but the amount of time that they spend making sure that for those of you that are traveling, you stayed in your hotel rooms and didn't sneak off somewhere else in the city, or any of the other things that we know happen, I just want to say to all of our instructors and all of our people who came to make this happen, thank you. It's all of your hard work that really makes this possible. The other incredible thing that happened tonight is not just that you performed fantastic music and told a story with it. It's that you played to a packed house. It's been a long time in APAC that we've had an event where we've entirely filled the house and there are people standing around hoping to get in to see it, as well as a lot of people live streaming. So for all the parents and guests and everybody that's still here or waiting out, thank you for joining us. We appreciate you coming and supporting students and making this possible. With that, thank you guys so much. Look forward to watching you celebrate later at the dinner and continuing to develop. Thank you.
Thank you. Students, now the spotlight is back on you. We are going to bring up each of our schools. Each school will receive a recognition plaque, and each participating student and director and chaperone will also receive an APAC patch. So we will bring you up school by school, beginning with the American International School of Guangzhou. Come in front of the table for our photo, please. If everyone could step in front. But you don't slip. The next school up, the International School of Beijing. Big enough group, you might even need to do two rows. Let's see. Next up on stage, also from Beijing, the Western Academy of Beijing. Congratulations to WAP. Next to be recognized, Shanghai American School, Pudong Campus. I think we're going to need two rolls, are we? Congratulations. Shanghai American School, Puxi Campus, next to be recognized. Come on up. And your hosts, Concordia International School, Shanghai. Congratulations, thank you. And there's one final group. This group, it's going to be their last APAC Orchestra, and for most, it's probably their first, at least in this scale. And so that group are the class of 2024. Can we ask all of our seniors to come up here for a group photo? Thank you. Thank you. silly one? Are we going to do a silly one as well?
Let's hold Connor off.
No.
Nothing too dangerous. We're going to miss you guys next year and a lot of leaders in that group as well. Thank you so much. Okay, we're almost finished. You're probably students almost famished because you ate pretty early your lunch today. What we're going to do now is transition to the PC Commons, which is the same space where you have had lunch every day. So we're going to go there and have a banquet. There's food there prepared for you. And during the banquet as well, we have put together a little collection of photos from the last few days, and we'll be sharing that with you as well. We do have a backdrop outside. This is a good time if you want to get some photos taken out there as we transition over to the banquet. Any other messages, Mr. Roddick?
I realized during your performance that I should have mentioned to your parents before we started that our live stream feed that had three cameras and had audio from on the stage was also recorded, and we will share that with the schools. So I'm sorry, Mom, if you're holding a camera the whole time so that you can get a picture, but we will share that with the schools.
One last piece we would like to, and Mr. Winkleman did mention the backroom staff that put a lot of work into this. And so from our transportation office, our guards and security office in operations, from the marketing and communications team, we have had photographers and videographers. The live stream was actually run by the SMS High School Club, and we live streamed six full rehearsals as well as the live concert today. So a huge thank you to all of those people. And one person we haven't mentioned who we should is Miss Janet Wang, our assistant in the activities and sport department, who has done so much work behind the scenes. Thank you all for everything that you have done. We are about 7 minutes ahead of schedule, so there is time for us to transition over to the banquet. Enjoy the time to socialize. Have a great evening and safe travels home, everyone. Thank you.